are who we are.
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
That's right.
In the name of Jesus.
Glory.
So when Jesus, amen, saw the devil, amen, Jesus, and the devil began to talk and say, what you want to do with me? The devil was asked, are you come to destroy me?
Jesus.
Hallelujah. He said, because I know thee, who art thou, the Holy One of God. He knew who Jesus was.
That's right.
I know you. Are you coming to destroy me? Hallelujah, hallelujah. The devil wants to, hallelujah. I wish he could say that to some of us. When we walk in the room, are you coming to destroy us? But he can't say that to us, because we're not what we need to be. Hallelujah. We can't turn down our plate a little bit. Hallelujah. We can't fast. Hallelujah. We can't stay in the word. Hallelujah. So we never can get to the place that God has for us. So the devil is never going to run from us, because we don't have nothing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. So when the devil said that to Jesus, Jesus rebuked him and saying, hold thy peace and come out of him.
Glory.
In other words, he told him to be quiet.
Yes.
Hold your peace, be quiet,
amen,
and come out of him.
Jesus,
right. Jesus rebuked him.
Yeah.
And when he rebuked him, he was stern with it.
Yeah.
He wasn't quiet. He wasn't acting like he didn't know what he was talking about. Because every time he opened his mouth, he spoke with authority.
Yeah.
When he spoke, hallelujah, the devil had no choice but to leave.
Hallelujah.
When he told him to hold your peace,
yeah,
and come out of him. And when the devil had thrown him in the midst, they said the devil told this man in the midst, had him all over the floor, amen, in the name of Jesus. But he came out of him, and he did not hurt him, he said. He came out of him and did not hurt. Because Jesus told him, come out of him.
All right.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
When Jesus speaks, things happen.
Yeah.
We need to be like that. When we need to speak, things happen.
Yeah.
When we open our mouth, people need to be running.
Hallelujah.
When we walk in the room, people need to be moving out the way.
Yeah.
If they're not living right, if they're not walking right, if they're not talking right, when you come in the anointing one,
yeah,
they should be able to see something in you. They need to flee in so many different directions. Move out of your way. Because they can't stay under the anointing.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
So the people witnessed this and they were amazed at the authority that Jesus had to be able to cast out the demon spirit. Hallelujah. They were amazed. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus, of what Jesus was able to do.
Hallelujah.
They spoke among one another and said, what is the authority that he has? He has the authority and the power to command the unclean spirit, and they came out.
Amen.
So I come to tell you again, we need to use our authority. We need to get where we need to be, hallelujah, so that we can use our authority.
Amen.
We have the same power that Jesus has, nothing different. Amen. God left that power for us, amen, in the name of Jesus. But you have to apply yourself. You have to want this thing,
yes,
hallelujah. You have to want it foremost than anything in the name of Jesus. And spend that time with God, hallelujah. Jesus used his authority, hallelujah. He used his authority all over the Bible, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. So in my conclusion, I want to tell you on today's time, to use your authority.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. It's time to use your authority.
Yeah.
Jesus used his authority when it came to Lazarus in the name of Jesus. We know the story about Lazarus. Lazarus was dead for 4 days in the name of Jesus. Jesus came and used his authority.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. He went, hallelujah, and told them to move the stone. And they told him, look, they said that he'd been there for 4 days.
That's right.
And he may be smelling right now. And may be older there right now. But Jesus didn't feed into that, amen. He told them to move the stone,
right,
amen, because he's about to use his authority.
Yeah.
He was about to show them what he's made of.
Yeah.
And they had all the crowd around them, and they wondered why Lazarus was dead. Jesus was able to open the blind eyes. He couldn't save Lazarus, because they're sitting there, always have somebody mocking and always there looking and watching, always got something to say.
Yeah.
Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
So back then, they would always have something to say.
Yeah.
So Jesus had a crowd that was around him in the name of Jesus. He could have went right then to Lazarus when they told him that he was sick. But he waited 2 days in the name of Jesus to go there. Hallelujah. He had a plan and a purpose, and he had to go according to the plan. He couldn't run when he got the call that Lazarus was sick. He had to wait 2 days. So he got there. He was dead 4 days. So he moved the, told them to move the stones.
And
when they moved the stone away, oh God, from the tomb, and he began to look up, oh God, from where his help come from. And he began to look up to his father. He said, Father, I thank you, oh God, for always hearing me. Oh, Father, I thank you, oh God, for hearing my prayers. He began to thank his father in a tested.
My God.
He wasn't afraid. He didn't care about what anybody had to say.
No.
He didn't look at your faces.
Hallelujah.
He had a job, his assignment. He was on his assignment by any means necessary.
Yes.
And he finished his assignment all the way to the end.
Hallelujah.
No matter how he felt, no matter what he looked like, they hung him on the cross first. They whipped him all night long.
Yeah.
Amen. They put nails in his hands. They put nails in his feet. They put the crown of thorns on his head.
Yeah.
But he still did not give up, oh God, because he had us on his mind, oh God.
Yeah.
He loved us that much. He was willing to lay down his life for us.
Yeah.
So he didn't think about all of that, oh God.
Yeah.
He was on his assignment, and he wanted to finish his assignment by any means necessary.
Yeah.
So he went on the cross for you and I. And the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
They put the crown of thorns on his head. And he pierced him in his side.
Yeah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. He did all of that because he loved us. And the name of Jesus. And he still did that and used his authority, oh God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And then he died on the cross.
Yeah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. But he rose on the third day.
Yeah.
He rose on the third day. Using his authority, oh God. He rose on the third day with all power in his hand. Hallelujah, hallelujah. He used the authority God has given him. He didn't stop when it got hard. He didn't give up at the end, oh God. He went all the way till the end. So he used his authority, oh God. And he rose up, oh God, on the third day. And he's sitting on the right hand of our Heavenly Father.
Yeah.
And he taught us well when he was on this earth for 33 years.
Amen.
He walked in his authority.
Hallelujah.
He talked in his authority.
Yeah.
Preached in his authority.
Yeah.
Cast out demons in his authority.
Yeah.
He did so much, oh God, in his authority.
Yes.
And he left that for us to go on ahead and finish what he left off.
Amen.
And we need to go on ahead and do what God has called us to do.
Glory.
Walk into your authority.
Yes.
Talk using your authority. Stop letting people run all over you. Stop letting people treat you in your type of way. It's time to stand up.
Amen.
You are a child of the King. Don't allow yourself to be treated in your type of way.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes.